Hi everyone, welcome back. God is so good, he's good all the time, no matter what. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about waiting on God's perfect timing. If this is your first time here, welcome. I'm so glad that you are part of this family and God has ordered your steps to be here. It's not by chance. God doesn't work like that. So he has great and mighty things he wants to do in your life through this channel. I would like you to join the Facebook group where you won't be isolated. It's very hard to walk alone. So be part of the Facebook group. It's where prayer and fasting updates are announced. I want you to take note of the 17th of December, and this is for everyone. God has chosen this date. He has revealed it to me in a dream, and he wants us to cross into 2021 glorified. And this glory is going to let you shine all the way into 2021. And this is the day that we are going to pray together, and God is going to show up in a very big way. I believe that God has given you a promise. Maybe someone prophesied to you, or God has shown you something he wants to do in your life through a dream, vision, or through someone speaking and confirming that word. God does not make mistakes. God is a promise keeper. Whatever he has for you shall be fulfilled. He did it for Abraham. He promised a son, and Isaac came. He promised that I'll make you great and you will be the father of many nations. Abraham became. The promise went to Isaac, went to Jacob, went to Joseph. And all of us are enjoying the blessing of Abraham because our God is not man to lie and is not going to start now. God's time is the best. And I don't want you to start jumping ship because things are so hard. Because that promise God showed you clearly hasn't come to pass. Our God is faithful. And I want you to take this word and run with it. God is perfecting what he has for you. While you are waiting, God is doing great things behind the scenes. I spoke about this in the video that I did last week, and you can go and watch it. You'll be encouraged. 21 years ago, God gave me a prophecy through this man of God. He was 19 years old that time. Some of you have watched my testimony where God did a miracle for me to come out of that house. Before that miracle happened, I received a prophecy that I didn't take seriously. This man was invited by my aunt in that house to come and pray because my aunt was praying a lot. But the things they were doing were contrary to what they were confessing. That wasn't sitting well with me. And so anything that she was involved in, especially anything to do with God, I didn't want to believe. I thought it was just fake. How can a person who has Jesus in their heart behave that wickedly? So I just closed myself. And this man was invited. Maybe he was invited just for me. I don't know. But for them, they thought they invited this man to come and pray for them. He stayed there for 4 days. And the last day that the following day he was leaving, he called all of us to be prayed for. We were praising and worshiping, and I was just minding my own business. I was just talking to my God and offloading my issues to him. And everyone was praying, and this man stopped and came straight to me. This was shocking to everyone. They were expecting that this man of God was going to prophesy something negative over my life or something to do with demons or something like that. But this man came straight to me and laid his hand on my forehead and said, God is making you great. You are going to travel the world. And that time I had one pair of shoes. All I wanted was him to say, tomorrow you have a job and someone is going to come and you get married and you are going to be happy. He didn't say all that. He was talking about this language that was so strange to me that time. It was far-fetched. He said big things, and he was saying that you are going to be a blessing to many. Many lives will be blessed through you. I was like, me, I'm so confused. Hey, what is this man even saying? And he said, it shall be done. God has promised, and he will do it. I said, amen. But I was shaking because it came as a shock. And we finished praying, to cut the story short. People were expecting that this man was going to prophesy to them. He didn't prophesy to anyone except me. Except an orphan that didn't have a place to stay. Huh? Oh, this God. Wow, hey. Now, because this prophecy was prophesied over my life and I didn't look like that time, these people thought it was fake. You don't know what I went through after that meeting. I was mocked. People were laughing at me. They said all kinds of things. And because of that, I didn't take that prophecy seriously. But even if I didn't take that prophecy seriously, that word was planted over my destiny. No one can stop what God is doing. That you have to know. This is what Isaiah 14 verse 24 says. Read it. I'm not going to read it now. I'll paraphrase it. He says that I'll do it as I've planned it. As I've purposed it, so shall it be. Even if everybody else doesn't think God is doing great things over your life, even your own unbelief, God will supersede that. God will give you strength. God will help you because this is what has been embedded in your DNA. This is what God has said you are. So things can come your way and just choke this, choke that, but God will find a way of making sure that you become who He has called you to be. Whether generational curses or whatever is blocking you, whatever is trying to stop you, God is making sure that you get freedom. He will bring someone who is going to help you come out of that until what He has over your life comes to pass. This prophecy I received 21 years ago is still speaking even today. I still see a lot of things that man said happening today. It has taken a long time. I'm not saying in your own life it will be the same. I'm just giving you an example of my own life. So a prophecy will unfold slowly. While God is doing one thing that will lead to another, is making you stronger. Even problems that we go through, you getting muscles to stand in the presence of God and be able to say, I belong to Jesus. I claim everything that Jesus went to pay for on the cross. That prophecy has taken years. In 2007, I went to Thailand. I went to Laos. I went to Indonesia, to Belgium. And for the first time, I was in Italy. And I started to think, I said, that prophecy is what is happening now. But it didn't happen in one day. What God has spoken over your life won't happen in one day. Because God doesn't work like that. We want to microwave everything. God can give you something that you are not ready for and it will break you instead of blessing you. This is a good father we are talking about. Even Abraham did not become rich, become great in one day. It took years. He moved to another place, met different people, and he became who God called him to be. Wait on God's perfect timing. It's the best. You have a permanent blessing. And when he starts to unfold himself, it does not stop, no matter who stands against you on the way. So don't let anyone put you under pressure. Because disobedience is costly. People will pressurize you to do wrong things. You start to settle for something that is less than what God has for you. Psalm 37 verse 7. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospers in his ways, because of the man who brings wicked devices to pass. Your case is different. Don't compete with anyone else. What God has spoken over your life is for you, and it will happen for you. Do not waste time looking at somebody else's life. This is where we get it wrong. And we start to panic. We start to stress. And once you start to do that, faith disappears. You start to involve flesh. And when flesh is in control, anyone that comes your way, you believe. The enemy will start bringing his own gifts to you and you accept it. One thing I've come to know about God in all these years is that there's no wasted time with him. Your past, God will use it. Whatever mess is happening around your life or anything that has happened in your past, God is going to use that as well. He's going to take your past, the mess you've gone through, something that you're thinking is useless and is wasting your time. God is going to use that to propel you ahead. So there's no wasted years with God. God says that he's able to help you recover all the years that you have lost. I understand very well. I don't want to be super spiritual because I've been there. I know what waiting means. Waiting is not easy because while you are waiting, there's nothing happening around. But God has given us the grace, has given us patience. And patience is a gift that we can ask from God. God, help me. Give me patience. Help me to wait. Your life is not moving a single bit. And this is tough. You just want to have that good news. We all want that. But God's time is perfect. Why does he say that? Because while you are waiting, he's perfecting things and is making sure that once this blessing comes, it's not stolen. He prepares your character. He prepares you to receive. That's what a good parent does. We raise our children in a way that when we send them into society, they are not bringing shame to us. This is what God is doing right now. The next thing I want to talk about is, do you just sit and wait and do nothing about it? There are things that you must be doing while you are waiting. So how do you wait on God's perfect timing without losing your mind? You draw closer and closer to God. Make sure that you are praying more. Intensify your prayers. I've said it before and I'll say it again. There's no better place to wait upon God other than in his presence. There you are safe. You are protected. And the Holy Spirit is busy guiding you because God won't give you everything in one day. Even a step that you make today, like praying and fasting and reading the Word of God, that is preparation for you. That is helping you now to better yourself, to make sure that you hear God clearly. He's sharpening your ear. And that's what you are doing while you are waiting. Don't sit idly and just be gossiping. And now it's time to have a pity party where you prophesy doom to yourself the whole day. Or you are just depressed and you don't even know what to do. There's a lot that you can do. If things are getting worse, you have to run to God. And those that run to him, they are safe. The next thing you can do is to declare the word of God. Declare it with your mouth. In Job chapter 22 and verse 28 says, thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto you, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. So instead of confessing something that is not working, you say things like, God is turning everything around for my good. Thank you, Jesus, for giving me this breakthrough. I am so grateful that I have received my breakthrough. You confess things that you want to see, and not what you don't want to see. So your mouth must bring life. Be busy about the Father's house. Pray for someone who has the same need as yours. This is what Job did, and God turned his life around. in Job chapter 42, verse 10, God told Job to pray for his friends. And as he prayed for his friends, God blessed Job double. So this is the principle. Everything we are looking for is in the Word of God. So be busy about the kingdom of God. What pleases God is you praying for other people, is you helping someone else and forgetting your need. That's what we call sacrifice. And if you sacrifice like that, God is going to be busy about your own business, about your own life, about your children. He is going to be busy beautifying you, beautifying your marriage. There's no way you can be busy in the kingdom of God and your life is going down. It's not true. God is the rewarder of they that seek him diligently. And as you work in the Father's house, in the vineyard of the Most High God, God is going to make sure that in your own life there's abundance, there's peace, and there's joy, and everything is working out for your good. This is the protection and the insurance that you can put around your life. Barricade your life with these things. And because God is not man to lie, you are sure to receive everything that you're expecting God to do for you. So this is what I had for you. And I hope this video has been helpful. If you learned something from this video, please give it thumbs up, comment, like, and share. Watch other videos that I recommend at the end of this video. Support this channel by subscribing. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Stay blessed.